ask, okay? He's always ready to help. And what we're making? I should call this probably the most luxurious breakfast, but this is actually a dinner. People serve this for dinner in restaurants or in general. This is such a filling meal that I would suggest to take it as a breakfast. What we need? Oh, and how it's called? It's called Adjarian Khachapuri or Adjarian Khachapuri. It's a simple cheese bread topped with an egg or an egg yolk in this case. We need warm water. My water is a little bit hot. That's why I'm adding cold milk. I have about a cup of water. I'm adding half a cup of milk. What that will do is it will make the bread slightly softer and crispier. Maybe not crispier, but softer for sure. Okay, so I have my water and milk mixture. It has to be lukewarm, not too hot, not too cold. And then also, since this is a bread, we need yeast. I always use instant yeast, not an active dry yeast. So if you are using active dry yeast, make sure to activate before adding flour and the rest of your ingredients. 1.5 teaspoonful, okay?
One and a half.
And then also I will add some sugar, about 2 teaspoonful of sugar. Okay, put it. Normally my teaspoonful is like this. 2 teaspoonfuls of sugar. And then I am using avocado oil, any vegetable oil, about 1.5 tablespoons should work. You wanna do it? It always works. Eyeballing when making bread always works.
I can mix.
You wanna mix? Yes, of course.
Can I clean it up?
Mm-hmm. You can mix that. And also I'm going to add some salt, 2 tablespoons of salt and flour. Always go with unbleached. Salt, not yet. You need to wait. They say salt kills yeast, which is the reason you would need to add the salt a little bit later. Okay, so that's that. For flour, I was saying I always use unbleached all-purpose flour. Bleached is you made with bleach. It's not a good ingredient, not an ingredient. It's something that is not recommended for health issues. That's why go with unbleached always, all the time. Okay, so since he's mixing, I'll start adding flour. All you need is to make a smooth, non-sticky dough. That's all you need in this life. And I'll bring the cheeses later. Let's finish the dough and then go from there. Akka, how much did you eat the yeast? It didn't look enough. Okay, it will work. Okay, so I'll add the salt at this point and knead the dough. 2 teaspoons. Yeah, put it. My salt guy. And let's mix it, okay?
I got my sticky dough, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna do my strongest. Yes. I got my muscles.
Okay, okay. You mix it, I'll add the flour, okay?
Okay.
Mix it.
Look at my sticky dough.
Mm-hmm. Can I help?
No, I'm a big boy.
Yeah, big boys never need help, unfortunately. I love you.
Yeah, you can try now.
Okay, thank you. You're so sweet. Now you add some flour, okay? About 3.5 cups of flour.
Like?
Yeah, add another cup.
Yes?
Mm-hmm. No, let's wait. You don't want to add too much flour or else you'll have very stiff bread. Okay, now at this point I'm going to transfer this into my nicely cleaned surface and knead until it's smooth and non-sticky. You want to add just a little bit of flour here, Arka?
Yeah, a little.
A little, yes. That's perfect.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. That's it. You're done.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I'll call you when I need you with cheeses, okay?
Okay.
Thank you.
I get the cheese?
Mm-hmm.
But we don't have to scratch it?
We don't have to scratch it, no. Put a little bit more flour, Ka.
A little?
Mm-hmm.
Now what? Like this many?
More.
Now?
Put it.
On flour?
Mm-hmm.
I'm so good at this, right?
Mm-hmm. You're the best at this.
Mom, can I feel the dough?
Yeah, feel the dough.
It feels good.
It feels soft and smooth and not very sticky. You're gonna transfer it into greased bowl.
Right.
And let it rise an hour, or it depends. At this heat, everything, I mean the dough, especially with yeast, rises so quickly, like 30 minutes maximum. Okay, I'll cover this with a towel.
Oops.
And then I made one earlier. Let's let this rise.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is the one I made earlier.
Oh, that's a cool dough.
Look how happy this dough is.
Is it hot?
It's happy, no. It's dancing, see? It's bubbling.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Can I try it?
I think you need to wash your hands just in case. Lucy, not you. She's always ready to play with dough. And flour the surface. Remove the air. I mean, punch the air out of the dough. And divide it. This is slightly bigger portion because... Hey, stop making noises. Someone woke up. Someone noisy woke up. Okay. This is slightly larger portion because we're a big family. I always make almost double portion for this recipe.
My back.
Your back? Okay. I'm going to divide this into, let's say, five. I'll divide it into five portions and let it rise on my kitchen table as long as I need to make the cheese mixture. About 15-20 minutes.
I don't have bubbles.
Because it's a bubbly dough. Just a little bit. At this point, don't use too much flour.
Can I try?
I'm going to give you some to play with, okay? Just make it into a bowl, just like this.
I'm going to make that bowl.
Guys, this is not a cooking class. By the way, I have first cooking class, kids baking class this Sunday. If you're following me on Instagram or Facebook, I put the schedule in there. I can't wait to see my students. Not these students. They are my all-time students. Right, Lucy? Okay, into five. I'll make one small one for Beck. Okay. For Pickle.
I'll give it to Beck.
No, he's not gonna eat this now, Arka.
Why? You want for me?
And I'll make two medium ones for you and Lucy, yes. Now I'm gonna cover this with towel and go bring the cheeses. Mix the cheeses, fill the bread, bake, and everyone will be happy and full. This is such a filling bread. Mozzarella, shredded mozzarella. I never buy already shredded cheese. It's so dry. So I always shred it myself. No, you can't do this one. You want to do the egg? We also need an egg and feta cheese. Feta cheese, this one is Valbresso, but Bulgarian feta, any salty feta will work.
In here?
Yes, in there. Okay, so break it in here. And also, I like adding a little bit of yogurt and try to get, this is plain Greek yogurt, And this is quite loose, very liquid type of yogurt. Thank you, Arka. If the yogurt is very hard, mix it with some water. Some people make a mixture with milk and flour and add it to
the
filling. You want to put the cheese? Let's add some, about 2 tablespoons of yogurt. 2 or 3 tablespoons.
That yogurt is so spicy, right?
Spicy?
A little.
A little, yes. Okay, if he says so. Okay, so let me shred my cheese and I'll show you the rest.
Mom. Can I shred once?
No, it's dangerous. You can cut your fingers.
I'll not cut my finger. I'll do it gentle.
Orko. Come. My gentle guy. Okay. You need to come, Orko. I can't. Okay, hold on. There's cheese under. Okay, do it gently, okay?
This way?
Yeah. All of it.
What if we don't?
Nothing will happen. We'll have less cheese and be happier.
Yeah, what?
Okay, that one. Okay, the cheese is done. And I'm going to save some of the cheese on the side and mix some of it with feta. I'm going to crumble it with my fingers. You want to do that?
Huh?
Yes?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Because you never enjoy mixing things.
I do enjoy.
You will enjoy.
I enjoy now.
Now he enjoys it.
Right? Why is there water in there? It has sparkles, right?
Yeah, it's kind of gross. Okay. Okay, so you want to do this?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay. Sure. You need to crumble it very well to have smooth mixture.
So I have to use this melted thing?
Babe!
I can use this?
Yes, you can do it. Okay, let me add my mozzarella.
Okay.
No, crumble it. I'm not gonna shred it. We're done with shredding.
And go on from what?
No. Is it gonna be white? Or
I think we need more yogurt. You want this mixture to be kind of soft and smooth.
I'll put yogurt.
Yeah, put yogurt, another tablespoon or so. And you know, sometimes I also add farmer's cheese. Enough, that's enough. If you have farmer's cheese on hand, use it. It lightens the mixture. Okay, I'll mix this very quickly and start preheating my oven to 500 degrees Fahrenheit. Is ready. And if I didn't mention, I also started preheating a baking pan in my oven. Just put it in the center because you want to bake your khachapuri on top of hot pan. That way it will bake much better and you won't have any sagginess. Okay, so that's that. An important detail, by the way. And parchment paper. It's gonna be easier to transfer it on your hot baking sheet with parchment paper. And let me make a large one. Or maybe I'll make this medium one. Mm-hmm. And if you notice, the dough has risen and almost again doubled in size. So be sure to put them a little bit with space apart. Okay, let me just quickly grab some flour. Aka, what are you doing?
Yeah.
A little bit of flour. And these are like little boat-shaped cheese breads or bread stuffed breads, cheese stuffed breads. I'll open this slightly. And the dough is so smooth and so soft. Just what we needed. And I got a couple of questions because I filmed this about 2 years ago. Since then I perfected the recipe and technique, so I wanted to share this one in more details. People would ask me if they can make the dough ahead of time so they can bake it in the morning as a breakfast. Yes, you can do it. You can even shape it, prepare the whole thing and save it in the fridge. Just be sure to cover it with some plastic wrap. Okay, so I'll open this into kind of rectangle shape, and I am going to show you two ways of making this. First, this will be the first one, okay?
Okay.
Okay, let me transfer this onto my parchment paper. That way it's easier, so you don't have to move it around after you shape it. Okay, this will be the first version. You're gonna put the cheese all over the bread. Just leave half an inch from the edge.
Mom, put that thing.
Wait. No, I need to do this. Okay, and then you're gonna fold that over this cheese, just like this, and then here, just like so, and bring together and shape it into a pot. Seal the edges.
I need to do the edge.
You wanna do the edge? Just squeeze it from here. Yeah? Perfect. Mm-hmm. This one is ready for the oven. But before you place it in the oven, slightly drizzle, or some do it heavily. I never go heavy on these kind of things. It's already quite filling. Okay, I'll set this aside for a quick minute because my oven is preheating very slowly, gradually. Okay, I have another 2-3 minutes. I'll shape another one.
Is the fan going fast?
Huh?
Fast?
Yes, not too fast. The second one, let me show you. You're going to do a slightly differently. Okay, let's do this one.
Mom,
a little bit flour.
Okay, give those to you.
The next one you'll give me. You'll give it, okay?
Okay.
Again, same way.
Mom, try to do it to the eye.
This is gonna be a big one.
Cool.
Like into a rough rectangle, not perfectly shaped rectangle.
Mom, I can
you're gonna do this.
And I can squeeze
it. Yeah, you can squeeze it.
Two?
Okay, so squeeze this.
Okay.
Let me put it on my parchment and then. It's much easier when you do it on your parchment paper, so you don't have to transfer, especially when you put the cheese in there, it's much difficult. Huh? Okay, squeeze it. You squeeze it, I'll squeeze this one. After you squeeze it, you'll add the cheese. If you notice, we don't have cheese inside the dough, inside the bread. And I'll tell you why we don't need that cheese in there. More minutes for my oven to preheat and we'll go from there. The cheese will go on top, mozzarella.
You put mozzarella?
Mm-hmm. What you want to make sure, you need to use one salty cheese and another one melting and smooth creamy cheese. So just go from there. Any kind you can find, anything you have on hand will work just fine. Okay. So let's wait a few more minutes and we can start baking. It's at 500 degrees preheated. 515, 520 will work just as well. Different ovens, different temperatures, so you know your oven.
It's up.
I'm getting to know this new oven. So far, I love it. I baked bread the other day. Turn out perfect. Okay, you're gonna slide this gently onto that already preheated pan and bake about 15 to 17 minutes. Try not to overbake it either.
Press the button.
The button is already pressed. I love watching how it's rising, how it's baking. I miss that so much. Very simple things recently.
I like the Boogie Down.
Huh?
Do you like the Boogie Down song?
Boogie Down song? I love Boogie Down song. Should we listen?
Yeah.
And dance? Mm. No?
No.
Okay.
But just put it on.
Okay, I'll put it on. Is ready and I slightly raised the pan so it gets golden very quickly. This is my children's favorite version, so I'm not gonna add any eggs on this one. And let me show you the second one. Okay, so let this set for 6 seconds. Cool down, always be sure to cool down on the rug for a few minutes at least. And I'll bake this one and show you the second kind.
What do you want?
You sing, he was the song. Now that one is ready as well. But since I'm making it with egg, let me show you how it's done. So I'm going to take it from the oven very quickly. And while it's still hot, what we're gonna do is this. Very carefully, you're going to remove, like pull the cheese out and remove all the extra dough from in there. Oh, Lucy-chan, please bring a paper towel. This is something you don't want to eat, and trust me, this version, you're gonna love this version so much better. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Okay, let me quickly remove the dough. Just like that. Who needs extra dough, right? My son. He's already done. Are you done with half of it or not?
No, I just started.
You just started? I'm surprised you even waited this long.
I didn't know it was here.
It was here, Arna. Okay, so after you remove the dough, just like that, you're going to put some people put the entire egg. I like adding just the yolk. Just open. Anna, watch carefully and learn, okay?
I'm not putting egg in it.
Not, yeah, just in case you need it, okay?
I'll never eat
and
it.
And only a few minutes, like 2-3 minutes, just to slightly cook the yolk. And it's ready. Okay. Ready. Here. Let me pop this one in there, not to waste the heat. Okay. Today is our full meal day. Where is the bag? I forgot to bring my delicious, super filling cheese bread, or as they call it, Adjarian Khachapuri. And I love mine with black pepper. And people, I don't always do this, trust me. I probably never do this. They like adding some butter, like it's a cholesterol bomb. As if it's not very filling already. Just like so. And I'll probably let this set 3-4 minutes before I dig in, and just look how beautiful this looks. Isn't it beautiful? It is. The egg makes it look more appetizing to me, not for them.
Eggs are gross.
Eggs are eggs. Not gross, or
eggs
not.
Eggs are only good if you can't taste the egg.
But with yolk, you don't taste the egg. Trust me. And some people, I don't do this. I never do this. Some people also brush it with butter. How necessary is that, right? It gives nice shine, and especially for restaurants. Okay. Lucy, you want to continue this one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I want to.
She wants to shape one. No, let's, Lucy, let Lucy to finish. Okay, and how do we enjoy this? Arka, stop.
Okay, let's go do something else, yeah?
Okay, we'll grab the edge and dip it into this egg.
She doesn't want her.
Just like this.
Come on,
okay. Probably I'll eat the two edges and we'll be full. Very feeling so delicious. Try it, let me know how you liked it. Recipe will be on my blog at heghineh.com. As always, link for the recipe will be below this video. That's it. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon.
Mama?
Mama, I need toilet.